everyone, I'm Mao Rui.
Hello, I'm Wang Rong.
We are based in Shanghai, China.
Today, you're going to start your journey of learning Chinese with us.
I'm so excited. Let's get started learning Chinese.
Wait, what Chinese do you want to learn?
Isn't there just one kind of Chinese? How many Chinese languages are there?
Actually, the word Chinese refers to two big categories, Mandarin and Chinese dialects.
What is Mandarin?
Mandarin is the official language used all over China, based on the pronunciation of Beijing dialect.
And how many dialects are there in China?
Over 80.
That many?
Some ones you might have heard of, such as Cantonese, Shanghainese, and Sichuanese.
So, we are going to learn Mandarin, right?
Yes. It's called 普通话. When we use the word Chinese in our lessons, it means 普通话, Mandarin. Do you still remember our Chinese names? I am, she is.
That's too harsh. Let's show them.
What are these?
They are Chinese characters, 汉字, our writing system.
Oh, it's not easy. Is there a phonetic system as well?
Sure, that's what we call pinyin in Chinese, as shown on the top.
These ones look very similar to the alphabets in English. Sweet!
Actually, we didn't have the pinyin system until 1950s, when the new government tried to make Mandarin national.
Pinyin makes it easier for people to remember the pronunciations of 汉字, Chinese characters.
Exactly. That means we should start with pinyin.
And that is why we stress to you start with and focus on pinyin first, trying to be conversational, and then gradually learn some characters.
Most of these alphabets sound like English too. How will you pronounce the syllable M-A-O in my last name? Yes, I guess you are quite close. Mo, mo, ao, ao.
How about the sign above the alphabets? Very interesting.
They are marks for tones. We call it 声调 in Chinese.
What are the usages for 声调?
Chinese is a tonal language, which means different tones will, like in music, will change the meaning of words.
How does that work?
Well, we have four tones. When we apply them to the syllable M-A-O, we could get 猫, 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 猫. And they could have the meaning of cat, hare, rivet, and hat, depending on the tones used.
Oh, they don't sound easy. We'll get back to us in our following episodes, right?
Absolutely, step by step.
Okay, now let's summarize the roadmap of your Chinese learning journey. First, you're going to learn the Chinese alphabets, tones, and you will master Chinese pinyin. Then, you will use pinyin as a powerful tool to learn easily Chinese vocabulary, phrases, sentences, and finally gain conversational skills. Eventually, you will start learning some Chinese characters, and you will be able to read, write, and speak in Chinese. That's all for this episode. Thanks for watching. We will see you in the next one, in which we will talk about pinyin. See you soon!